we are back with ForeverFootballShow.com. We've covered everything about the Sounders, including their gameplay against Metapan this week. And since we're talking about the CONCACAF, let's start our traveling down America, passing through the Mexican League, talking a little bit Brazil and the Libertadores before we jump into the European leagues. The Mexican Apertura, which is the... In Mexico, they play always two tournaments every year, Apertura and Clausura. This is the Apertura of the season 2010-2011. They're in the second round, and so far the leading teams are Santos and Cruz Azul. Actually, the same two teams that are doing the best, they are also playing the play-ins for the CONCACAF, and they also acquired advantages in their plays against their opponents. So both Santos and Cruz Azul doing very well in both tournaments. The local Mexican team, the Mexican tournament, and the CONCACAF League. And the highlight for the Mexican Apertura is this team called Querétaro. They were just upgraded. They just came from the second division, playing for the first time in the first division, and they're in the third position. Still too early, only two rounds, but showing potential. Who's your favorite team to win the Mexican League?
Honestly, I don't follow the Mexican league as much as I like, but I'll go with the Monterrey.
Monterrey is a good team. They're doing well.
You know, I can tell you something about Mexican league. You know, in my opinion, I think Mexico was one of the best teams in the last World Cup. Mm-hmm. They got just a laggy with Argentina, and we all knew what happened during the game. Because the goal that Argentina scored, first goal with Tevez, changed the story of the match. And they had very good players. And, you know, the name of the guy that went to Manchester
United? Chicharito.
So I guess people should pay more attention to Mexican League because they are doing great. After a period of dark in 1986 with all this... famous players. After that, there was a period of dark for Mexican League, but now they're coming back again.
Well, in my opinion, it's going to be a natural consequence of this CONCACAF tournament. The American teams giving more importance to that tournament, and the Sounders as well. It's going to be a natural consequence that we'll start tracking more what's going in that tournament as well, because we want to know, we want to sort of calibrate how well we're going to be able to play against the Mexican teams in CONCACAF. So we'll have to know what's going on in their local tournament as well.
Yeah.
The other thing about the Mexican League is that, you know, this is the first year, actually, now that we're going to talk about Libertadores. The Mexican teams always send teams to play both CONCACAF and Libertadores, the South American League. And this is the first time that a Mexican team advanced all the way to the semifinals. The Chivas Guadalajara, not only they beat Manchester United in a friendly yesterday, 3-2, they are also doing very well in Libertadores, and they're in the semifinal. They tied Universidad Católica in Chile. And 1-1, so that puts them in a tough situation for the next game, but they have a chance to advance to the final.
Wow.
As a matter of fact, if you check the highlights, the YouTube highlights that we always keep in our website, you'll see the goals of Libertadores, all the games from the Sounders. There's going to be the games from the other semifinal Libertadores as well, São Paulo and Internacional. So a great face-off between Inter and São Paulo. They've been two recent champions of Libertadores as well. So the four teams in Libertadores now are Inter and São Paulo from Brazil, Chivas Guadalajara from Mexico, and Universidad de Chile. So whoever wins that will join Inter Milan in the FIFA Champions.
São Paulo, honestly. I want to see Neymar.
No, Neymar is from Santos, actually.
So you're right.
Yeah.
You're right.
Exactly. Now, talking about that, Santos is in the final of the Brazilian Cup. And they won 2-0 against Vitória.
And then he's the winner of the game.
Tell us about it.
Yeah, it was fun. It was Neymar first. He was able to get this penalty kick. And I guess the defender is still thinking about it because he understand where the ball was. And then he went to shoot the penalty kick and... Actually, it's something bad.
He went to imitate Loco Abreu.
Yeah.
Like he scored the last goal for Uruguay against Ghana.
Yeah, right. And you know, the first guy that made it was Totti in the European League. He did that against Holland. And in Italy we call that cucchiaio, it means spoon. Just because it's kind of irreverent for the goalkeeper. And then
Robson, but he missed, totally missed. But
yeah, he just tried his little chip right in the middle of the goal. The keeper was just there, raised his hands, picked the ball, and started a counterattack. Still that, Santos won 2-0. Neymar scored the first goal. The fans were a little bit annoyed, but Neymar is in great shape, and he's actually going to the he's going to play for the Brazilian side against U.S. next week. He was called for the first time by the new management in Brazil.
How old is he? Is he 18 or 17?
18. Yeah, very young player, very talented. He's going to be in the Olympics playing for Brazil for sure.
Wow.
He needs to mature a little bit. You know, all that Santos team, they play, they have like four or five players under the age of 21. They're all in age of playing for the Olympic Games. But they are so like they tease the other opponents. They make dances. They are kids playing and having fun. But very soon they'll have to get a little bit more serious when they play. But that covers for the Libertadores, South American, Mexican leagues, and all that. We're gonna go for a quick break and come back with all European games. Actually, the European games are being played here in the U.S. soil. We'll be back with ForeverFootballShow.com.